All right. Have all of you tried this RCS MCET completed?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Sir.
All right. 121. Anybody has any doubt? Okay, no doubt. One 123, any doubt? Okay, these two questions, 124 and 125. I hope we discuss different methods for common cot. Depending on the question, you can do the other methods. Okay, up to 126. Not right. Uday, you are saying something I could not hear clearly.
Sir, 127.
127, okay. The equation of the circle passing through the points of intersection of the circle and the circle and cutting this orthogonally. Okay. I think you know the method. I don't know if answer is not something wrong with the question, that part I don't know. Otherwise, you subtract. Basically, we have two circles which are intersecting. There are two points. There is some other circle. A particular circle is like this, passing through point of intersection of these two and intersecting the orthogonal. What is that? Okay. So this is S1 and this is S2. This is S1 minus S2. When you subtract, you will get 10x plus 10y. That is 10 times x plus y equal to 0. So you can even call x plus y. Now I can use s plus lambda. Any circle passing through these two will be first circle or second circle plus lambda times this. That is x square plus y square plus 4x plus 6y minus 12 plus lambda into, I can take 10 into x plus y, only x plus y I can take. Okay. Now I can use to orthogonality condition with this one. This is x coefficient is 4 plus lambda into minus 2. 6 plus lambda into 1 and c plus c dash constant is minus 12 plus 8. From this I should be getting lambda. Minus 2 lambda plus lambda is minus lambda. Minus 8 plus 6 minus 2. Of course that side as plus 2, it will be minus 2. Lambda equal to 2. When you put it, we'll get x square plus y square plus 6x plus 8y minus 12. Is it okay? 127?
Yes.
It doesn't take much time. If you understand properly, you can do it. If you get habituated. Up to 128, anything else?
No, sir.
Okay. So there your doubt is clear, right? Uday, are you there? Okay. 129, any doubt? 129, 130. Okay, I think 131 I have to discuss.
Yes.
Sir, no option is there, sir.
Oh, okay. I think you should come C square equal to A square into 2 plus M square.
Yes, sir. 2 plus
okay. M square. Is that a doubt or somebody has doubt about how to do this?
How to do it?
Okay. The circle which cut each other orthogonally and passes to the points a comma 0 and minus a comma 0. All right. A comma 0 for the point system. A comma 0. Okay. So passing through A comma 0 and minus A comma 0, there are a lot of circles. And let's say given line is like this. Passing through these two and touching this, there are two circles. One is this one, and one is a circle like this. Something like this. I should have drawn circles first. Anyway, this is a comma 0. This is minus a comma 0. Passing through these two, there are infinite circles. Among them, only two circles will touch the given line y equal to mx plus c. And those two circles are intersecting orthogonally also. For that to happen, what is the condition? I'll tell you somewhat an objective method, may not be complete at the end, but let us do subjectively. All circles passing through the point of intersection of these two points will be in the form of s plus lambda l equal to 0. For that, I have to know one circle in this family and radical x of this family. That one circle is, take these two as n subdiamond. Okay. So that is actually x square plus y square minus a square plus lambda into the radical x is x axis, which is y equal to 0. Whatever lambda you take, lambda 5 or 100 or 1000, doesn't matter. This circle will always pass through a comma 0 minus a comma. You can check it. If you substitute a comma 0, it will come 0. If you substitute minus a comma 0, also it will come 0 without any lambda, whatever lambda it is. Now, for a particular lambda, it will be this circle. For another particular lambda, it will be this circle. How to know them? First of all, it is x square plus y square plus lambda y minus a square equal to 0. This circle should touch this line. So from the center, perpendicular is equal to radius. Center is minus lambda 0 comma minus lambda by 2. And radius is lambda square by 4 plus a square. From this point to this line, the perpendicular distance, bring y this side, put this as 0, y as minus lambda by 2. I'll get minus lambda by 2 plus c by root over 1 plus m square. That is the perpendicular distance. That should be radius lambda square by 4 plus a square. Actually, if I take 2 lambda, it will be a little easy to write, but nothing wrong. Somebody can take 2y also here. It can take 2 lambda, nothing wrong. I'll get minus lambda here, 5-4 will not be there. Minus lambda, this will not be. But doesn't matter, you can do either way. Okay. Now I have to bring this side and square it. I'll get lambda square minus 2 lambda c plus c square. The other side, lambda square into 1 plus m square plus a square into 1 plus m square. Lambda square, one lambda square will cancel. So I'll get a quadratic equation in terms of lambda square. Lambda square into minus m square plus lambda into minus 2c plus c square minus a square into 1 plus m square equal to 0. Okay, this will cover all the circles passing through these two points. For which lambda, it will be this particular circle is from the center of that perpendicular distance equal to radius, it should touch this line. This is a center, this is a radius. I have done this. I got this equation. I can find the roots. This is after all a quadratic equation. I can find the roots. It will come like thirds kind of thing. But I'll assume lambda 1 and lambda 2 are the roots. When I substitute lambda 1, here you'll get one circle. Lambda 2, here you'll get another circle. But they should intersect orthogonally. What are the orthogonality condition for that lambda 1 circle and lambda 2 circle? 2g z dash plus 2f f dash equals c plus 2 dash. 2g z dash is 0. 2f f dash is 2, lambda 1, lambda 2 equal to c plus c dash is minus a square minus a square. Okay. If you cancel 2, you'll get lambda 1, lambda 2 equal to minus a square. And lambda 1, lambda 2 is product of the roots. That product of the roots is c square minus a square into 1 plus m square by minus m square equal to minus a square. Bring this one here and send everything that side. You'll get c square by a square into 2 plus m square. Is this okay, Pranay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sridevi, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, this is a little lengthy question. Okay, I'm going to erase. Anybody want some time to see? All right. Okay. If options are properly given, I want to tell one objective method. What is that? I want to take m equal to 0. Where can I take m equal to 0? Then it will be a horizontal line. I cannot take here. Yeah, here it is not possible, but because m is not defined for a vertical line. But if two circles are of equal radius and a line like this, we'll be able to find some condition, but the whole thing reverse, it is easier. Okay, leave it. Yeah, instead of a comma 0 minus a comma 0, if they would have given 0 comma a and 0 comma minus a. Okay, you can do something. We got option D only, na? Sorry, I was thinking something.
2 plus m squared, not 1 plus 2 m squared.
We got 2 m squared plus 1 only, man. Why? We got c square equal to c square minus a square into 1 plus m square equal to, we got a square m square, right? On the right side?
No, sir.
Just now we erased it. Did we get a square m square also, na? Here. Why m square was here, na? In the product of the roots. There's a minus here, there's a minus here.
Yes.
Answer correct or?
Yes.
Okay.
Sir, I took screenshot, sir. In that you wrote 2 plus m square only.
I wrote, but the previous step, I wrote that one wrong. Whatever the previous step. Sending m square this side after that, m square and this m square together 2 m square only. Option D is right. When that answer will come, I'll tell you. Instead of a comma 0, the original question was 0 comma a and 0 comma minus a.
Yes, sir. 2 a square m square only.
Yeah.
Last one you wrote wrong.
Yeah, yeah. The last but one step after that correct, but only last one wrong. Okay. When you take 0 comma a and 0 comma minus a, then we'll get to what you're saying. This answer is right option D. Absolutely no problem. Okay. 132. Anybody has doubt?
Sir, how did you say that 0 comma a and 0 comma minus a? In that case, that
is simply interchanging x and y everywhere. Y equal mx plus c. Why? Because I discussed that question earlier, but when you take product of the roots, c square minus a square into 1 plus m square, by m square will not come, by 1 will come there. And when you take a square, it will come, only a square will come, so this 1 will become. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
In the up to last step, more or less same, but in the product of the roots, this m square will not come. Because that is not lambda y, it will be lambda x. When you take the general circle passing through 0 comma and 0 comma minus. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Quantity 2, anybody has doubt?
Yes, sir.
What is this? If the for the yes. system of the circles where lambda is a parameter, if the line joining the points of the circles of the system, point circles of the system, okay, circles of radius zero, okay, in the bracket it was not typed properly here. Circles of zero radius, not a radius, circles of zero radius. Point circles means we know what are they, right? Okay. So basically the question is, this is a family of circles in that only two circles have zero radius. Okay. They are called point circles. And those two points, when you join to origin, that angle is 90. All right. That means, let us say origin is here. Let us say this is where I'll take this point and this point. Yeah, I'll take this. Okay, let us say I have a family of circles like this. Okay, there's a family of circles. In that family, there are only two points. There are also circles in that family, but they're point circles. Those two, when they are joined to origin, that angle is 90. For that to happen, what is the condition? That is the question. Is the question clear?
Yes.
Okay. Instead of s plus lambda s dash, I can convert this question into s plus lambda l also. How? What is l will be s minus s dash? What are the circles involved? If I subtract, I will get 2gx minus 2fi minus k equal to 0. Okay, 2gx minus 2fi minus k equal to 0. So same family, I can change it. But yeah. So any circle in this family can be written as x square plus y square plus 2gx plus some lambda you can write, or t you can write, doesn't matter. Into this line also you can write 2gx minus 2fy minus k equal to 0 also. Now how to find point circles in this family? Find radius and equate it to 0. X square plus y square plus 2g into 1 plus t into x minus 2fty minus tk equal to 0. What is the center of this? Minus g into 1 plus t and ft. What is the radius? Root over g square into 1 plus t whole square plus f square t square plus tk. That should be 0. When you solve this, you'll get a quadratic equation in terms of t. You'll get two values for t. You have to put it back. And then the point circles, if this is origin, one of the centers is some c1, one of the centers is c2. I have to take product of the slopes minus 1. For example, okay, anyway, let me expand this and see what is the quadratic equation. T square into what is the coefficient here? Here g square and here f square. T. Here 2g square and here t. Now here k. And constant is g square equal to 0. Okay. So any circle in this family, I can write s plus lambda s dash originally, or I can write s plus tl. I found the center and radius. Radius, so I want it to be 0. They are called point circles. I can find the roots of this, thirds will come, but I'll take the roots as t1 and t2. T1, t2 are roots. When I put the t1 and t2 back, what are the corresponding point centers, or point circles or point centers? Minus g into 1 plus t1, comma f t1. Minus g into 1 plus t2, comma f t2. What is the product of the slopes? This slope and this slope, total slopes is minus 1 means. F T1 my minus G into 1 plus T1 into F T2 by minus G into 1 plus T2 equal to minus. Now I have to substitute T1, T2, all these values. Okay. So F square by G square into T1, T2 by 1 plus T1 into 1 plus T2 is equal to minus 1. I have to substitute this. What is T1, T2? The product of the roots. G square by G square plus F square. What about 1 plus T1 into 1 plus T2? According to quadratic equation, this can be written as G square plus F square into T minus T1 into T minus T2, because they are the roots. You all know that AX square plus BX plus C can be written as A into X minus X1 into X minus X2. They are the roots. If I want 1 plus T1 into 1 plus T2, I have to substitute T as minus 1. If I substitute T as minus 1, what will happen? F square by G square into T1, T2 is G square. I'm not writing down G square plus, okay, I can write it G square plus G square. What about 1 plus T1 into 1 plus T2? I have to put T equal to minus 1. When I put T equal to minus 1 everywhere, here what will happen? G square plus F square minus 2G square and this G square, they cancel. F square will come, minus K will come. F square minus K by G square plus F square equal to minus. That may be a little confusing for some people, I'll explain. G square plus F square will cancel, this G square will cancel, this is going that side. I'm getting F square equal to minus F square plus K. 2F square equal to K. They might have asked F square by K or something like that. Yeah, K by F square, answer is 2. Sanjana, is the board clear to you?
Sir, now it is clear, sir.
Okay. For others, is the board clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So overall method, I'm explaining once again. I would have taken S plus lambda S dash the way they gave, okay? But I'm taking S plus lambda L because it will be easy to deal. Otherwise, here X square, Y square coefficients are 1. Otherwise, X square, Y square coefficients will not be 1. But still not an issue. It doesn't matter maybe, but okay. I subtracted the two circles, that is I got line, and I wrote S plus lambda L equal to 0. This is a general circle in that family. I want the radius to be zero. They're called point circles. So I found center and radius. I equated radius to zero. I got a quadratic equation in terms of T, this one. For the two roots are there, I call T1 and T2. Based on that, any quadratic expression can be written as A into X minus X1 into X minus X2. Like that, this leading coefficient is G square plus F square into T minus T1 into T minus T2. This is like A, this is like X minus X1, this is like X minus X2. Now, when I found the centers, put T1, we'll get one center, put T2, we'll get another center. This slope and this slope product is minus 1. Okay, that is this step. I have to find T1, T2 from this quadratic equation product of the roots. And 1 plus T1 into 1 plus T2. I can expand and find some other roots product of the roots or some way find this. Where I kept T equal to minus 1, I was able to get the denominator. This part. Then when I simplified, most of the things got cancelled. I got equal to. Anybody still any doubt regarding 131? Especially whoever asked out about 131, are you clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this 133 is quite similar to the other question, right? C square equal to A square into 1 plus 2m square. You can just do it. Answer should be A, I think. Anybody any doubt? How to do 134? Anybody want to tell?
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, first we find the tangent of the curve at 2, 4, sir.
Yes, correct.
Find its perpendicular at that point, sir. Means normal at that point, sir. It should pass to the center. We'll find general point. We'll find general point on the line and equate the distance from the point at 0, 1.
Yes, correct.
Otherwise, we can find the point circle at the 2, 4, and then substitute 0.
Yes, S plus lambda L also can be used there. Okay, question is actually y equal to x square is a parabola like this. Two comma four is there, one tangent is there. Touching this at this point, there are a lot of circles. All are touching the parabola. But a particular circle is like this, where it is passing through 0, 1, which is 2, 4. Okay? They want that circle. Yeah, you can do S1 equal to 0, you'll get this tangent with parabola. If you don't know about parabola, you know, probably first year tangents and normal chapter, you know. How will you find equation tangent at any point? Find dy by dx. Dy by dx is 2x and the slope is 4. So this line equation will be 4x minus y equal to 4. This line. Okay, now somebody can find this line, the perpendicular normal. That will be x plus 4y is equal to 18. You can take any point on that as some t comma. Even x is t, y will be 18 minus t by 4. From that you can equate distance to this. Or somebody can find perpendicular bisector of these two and solve with this normal, you'll get center. If you know two points on a circle, you can find perpendicular bisector of that chord. That also should be normal. This also should be normal to the circle. So all the two normals will get the center circle. Or somebody can take point circle and S plus lambda L they can use. X minus 2 whole square plus Y minus 4 whole square minus 0. That is the point circle plus lambda into the radical axis, this tangent, 4x minus y minus 4 equal to 0. You should pass to 0, 1. Substitute 0, 1, you'll get lambda, put that lambda back, you'll get the circle, then you can find the center. Okay. Otherwise, perpendicular bisector, you find it. Is it okay, 134?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 135, any doubt? No doubt. 136, anybody any doubt? Up to 140. Okay. Other doubts I want to discuss tomorrow. Other advanced material will not be discussing enough today. So you might have tried up till end, but I'll discuss tomorrow. So I'm giving enough time for somebody if has any backlogs. So by tomorrow, whoever not completed, they can try all the questions by tomorrow, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. So now we'll go for advanced material. And after MCET is over, I'm going to start discussing advanced material also, even numbers doubts. Okay. Yeah, we are discussing this 25th question yesterday. Stopped in between. Okay, so yesterday mainly I was making this, just to quickly repeat what I said yesterday. Okay, yesterday I said if two points are there, A and B, fixed. If there is a variable point P such that PA square plus PB square equal to constant. Depending on that constant, there will not be any locus, no locus. Or there will be a locus and that will be a circle with a midpoint M as center and suitable radius, some radius. Either no locus or a circle with this. What is that k, minimum k value? Anybody want to tell?
AB square by 2.
Yes. Because if you take midpoint itself, this is AB by 2, this is AB by 2. AB by 2 whole square plus AB by 2 whole square is total AB square by 2. So when K is less than AB square by 2, there will not be any such point. And when K is greater than or equal to AB square by 2, the locus of P is a circle with M as the center and maybe radius 0, radius 1, whatever, different radius. Similarly, if I have 3 points, A, B, C, okay? Even if they're collinear also, it's still something is there, but if they're not collinear, then whenever you take PA square plus PB square plus PC square equal to some constant, till some constant, no locus. After that, it will be a circle with centroid of triangle ABC as a center. Okay, if you take centroid as G, try to find GS square plus GP square plus GC square. When K is exactly that, locus is only G. Anything more than that, you'll get different concentric circle, but all of them will have center G. And we give explanation by algebraic way is better. We write x minus x1 whole square here, x minus x2 whole square, x minus x3 whole square. We'll get 3x square minus 2x into x1 plus x2 plus x3, so on. When you divide the 3, x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 is the centroid x coordinate. Similarly, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Similarly, for 4 things. Coming specifically to square. If they, all these are L, and if you take in circle, you take, and this is four corners A, B, C. You take any point on this in circle, from that find a distance to A, distance to B, distance to D, C, distance to D, sum of the squares is constant. If somebody want to know what is that constant, you take convenient point, it is easy. From here to here, distance to A is L square, distance to B is L square, distance to C is this square plus this square, Pythagoras theorem, L square plus 4L square is 5L square, this is also 5L square. Total it will be 12 L square. Okay. Now, whether it's constant or not, we are not proved it. We understood it already. How, even the point is changing, is constant. If you want, you can take really 0, 0, L, 0, and all that, take X, Y, really find this, we'll get it. Not a big issue. So I'm not necessarily going to prove. Okay. How it is a constant already explained. I'll just do it in a shortcut way. One time I take in circle, another time same square, but I have to take circumcircle. Or so here the side is 2n. So these are 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2 A, B, C, D. And this is for it's inscribed in circle C1. This is circle C1. This is circle C2. P is any point on this. So I'll take conveniently P here and I'll take conveniently Q here. So now coming to the question. If you want PA square plus PB square, PA square is 1 square, PB square is 1 square, PC square is 1 square plus 2 square by Pythagoras theorem. This is 1, this is 2. PD square is also 1 square plus 2 square. If I take QA square, it's 0 square, PB square is 2 square, QC square is 2 square plus 2 square, QD square is again 2 square. That is 5 plus 5, 10, 12. This is all our fours only. Yeah, how many fours? Four fours are 16. Four threes are four fours are 3/4. Is it okay, 25?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I already understood that you take any point, some of the squares is constant. So I took convenient point. All right, let us see 27. The center of circle passes into the point and just now this we saw in MCET, right? 27?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I know this question is there from long time in our material. So not required 27 now. 29 is also there somewhere we discussed it. Okay, 29, the given one is anyway tangent to the first circle, okay? Y equal to mx minus d root 1 plus m square is already tangent to x square plus y square equal to b square. Now we want it to be tangent to the second one. Okay. So what is the center of the second one? A comma zero and the radius will be. Okay, from center perpendicular equal to radius, you can apply that way. Or you can even take general tangent of the second circle and compare. We'll discuss both. From A comma zero, what is the distance to this? MA minus zero. I can bring this side as MX minus Y minus B. MA minus zero minus B root of 1 plus M square by root M square plus 1 with M mod is equal to B. That is mod MA minus B root of 1 plus M square is equal to B root M square plus 1. Plus or minus 2 case, you can take MA minus B root 1 plus M square is equal to B root 1 plus M square, or MA minus B root 1 plus M square equal to minus B root 1 plus M square. Here they'll cancel, you will not get anything. And it's 0. Don't want that. Coming to this, MA is equal to 2B root 1 plus M square, square it. M square A square equal to 4B square plus 4B square M square. What is it they want? M value. Okay. So I have to bring this one this side and send that from M square equal to 4b square by a square minus 4b square. Then M is a plus or minus root over whatever 2b by root over root. Another way to do is the general tangent to the second circle is y equal to m into x minus a. Plus or minus b root 1 plus m square. Because wherever x is there, at rate x minus. Now, y equal to mx minus am plus or minus b root 1 plus m square. I can take plus and equate to this. Okay, I can take minus and if I take minus, there's no use because this should be 0, it can't be. So I have to take plus here and then equate the constants. I'll get same step as this. Minus am plus b root 1 plus m square should be this. I'll do that here also. Okay, here we'll get and get AM equal to 0. Is it okay, 29?
Yes, sir.
Okay. M equal to 0 is also okay, not there in option, but sure. So you complete 29, you can try 31, then 33. Full questions. Many of you have to put on your video, Pradeep, Chandana, Kalyan, Hare Krishna. 31. Just what is the center of the first circle? 4, 1, and radius is root of 16 is 4. Center of the second circle is -3, -4, and radius is 5. When you find C1, C2, distance between the centers, root of 7² + 5². That is definitely root 49 + 25. Root 74 is roughly 8 point something. So root 74 is between 4 + 5 - 5 - 4. So C1, C2 is less than R1 + R2 and more than mod R1 - R2. So they're intersecting. There will be only two common tangents. All right. How to do 33?
Subtract the circles and we'll get a line equate this to this line.
Yeah, when you subtract, you'll get radical x, that should be the same as a given. Okay. So s minus s dash equal to 0. Is 5ax plus c minus t y plus a plus 1 equal to 0. That should be same as 5x plus by minus a equal to 0. We get 5a by 5 equal to c minus d by b equal to a plus 1 by minus a. If we take first and last and do cross multiplication, and get minus a square equal to a plus 1, a square plus a plus 1 equal to 0. That doesn't have any real roots. Okay, so that's why it's not possible. No solution. Because it's 35, every time I wanted to correct the question, now not getting time to give a proper question. But the question itself, if you want to find the actual answer, it's going to be quite lengthy. Okay. And what is the answer given is not the correct answer. Okay, 31, 33, already completed, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, 35. Before discussing this question, let me explain and then come back here. What is that? Let us say I have three circles of equal radius. Okay, three circles are of equal radius. I want a big circle. It should contain this circle, and this circle. So I can have a very big circle like this. But there will be a lot of such circles. Among them, what is the least circle? Circle with the least radius, how to find? These are, I know, I'll give you this center, this center, this center, and all are radius 2 units. And you want to give an idea how to do this?
Okay.
Yes.
The largest circle which is covering this way should touch two of the circles at least.
I'm not asking largest. I'm asking.
Least
one. Why only two? If not all three?
Sir, if you consider three, its size may increase.
No, I don't think so. I'll tell you why.
Sir, if you draw a circle with by taking that opposite circles as at the edges of the circles, you'll get one circle, sir.
Yeah, if you want to only contain these two, obviously I will take these two as ends of diameter and take that.
No, sir. Distant circles.
No, what I'm saying is, if I want to contain only these two circles inside, okay, then I'll directly draw the diameter, take these two as ends of diameter. I'm sure that is a circle of least radius which contain these two. Now I can have very big circles containing these two. For example, there can be a circle like this, or there can be a circle like this, or I can open it further, very big. But I'm sure there will be a circle containing all three just right. Right? Touching all three will be there. Okay.
Yes, sir, but I don't think that it will be minimum.
It will be the minimum. Why? If something is not touching all the three, it's going a little outside. You have to increase the size only. Compared to the one touching all three and another one touching two but not containing. Containing this but not touching, it will be bigger, right?
Sir, I can give an example, sir. So take three circles of equal size, which centers are collinear, sir.
Collinear is different. I'm not talking about collinear.
Yes, sir. Means collinear is it's a limiting case of the circles.
Not necessary. Let us say you want to take two circles here, a little bit off. Okay, I'll give you one circle.
No, sir. If you take three circles collinear, thinking should be true for that also. It's also a limiting case of that.
If you're taking three, I would just say take this point and this point as ends of diameter, directly draw the circle. That is the circle of least radius.
That's what, sir. This is the circle of least radius, sir. But it's not touching the third, the middle one, sir. if we want to take it, it's a little arm, it's a little up of the.
Okay. I understand what you are saying. You are saying a circle here where this circle has less radius compared to some other circle like this. You want to say
yes,
that?
Yes.
That is a good point. That means if acute angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle, it can matter, I guess. Okay. Yeah, your logic is good. I liked it. So it is not necessary to touch all three, you are saying. Okay. What is this noise? That's a good logic. So it is not necessary to touch all three. No doubt if something has to touch these two, there's a minimum radius. Okay, so it is okay. Now I got clarity that what I'm saying is three cases now I want to take. Yeah, the question is okay. So my question is same still. I have three circles, all are of equal radius in XY plane. How to find a circle of least radius containing all three? Now three cases will arise. I can even say four cases. Here the centers of all of them are collinear. Okay. Then we take, as I said already, you take this end point and this point, take those two ends of diameter. Okay. That will contain, and less than that, not possible because touching these two, that is a possible least radius containing. And the second case, when they are forming acute angle triangle, okay, or I can take acute angle triangle, C1, C2, C3 are forming an obtuse angle triangle. Then, if that is like this, and I have one circle here, one circle here, one circle here, still take these two as ends of diameter, the circle will be obviously inside. Doesn't have to go that much deep. Yes. What if they are forming a right angle triangle? Okay, if they are forming a right angle triangle, need not be isosceles, but like this. Then also take these two as ends of diameter, that will touch even this one also. Okay, perfectly it will touch all three. Nice. Am I right? Why it will touch? Because this is only circumcenter. This length, this length, this length are equal. Add extra two, extra two, extra two, they're equal, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, when it comes acute, that's where discussion comes. Okay. What if I have one here, and somewhere here? It's acute angle triangle. Then the one when you take these two as ends of diameter, definitely the circle lie outside or partly inside. Okay. Then you have to go for little circle like this. Okay. Then it will touch. So it also matters that the three centers you take and they should form acute angle triangle. Yes, is that? I'm sure I can make a nice matching with this. That is a very nice question there. Okay. I can fix two circles and third circle, I'll keep on changing the center. Okay, and I ask what are the radius, minimum radius containing all three. That's a good one. We can easily make. Okay, excellent. Would have discussed this question some days before. I was making some grand tests for your seniors. I would have made this matching, but it's a good discussion. Just recently, I kept a message to your seniors saying they can say thanks to me, but I'm saying thanks to all of them because the discussion every year from the students, I learn a lot or some ideas will come. Okay. So over the years, every year I see some students, sometimes they give an idea, sometimes they'll express a doubt, and through that I learn something. Okay. It gives me a better understanding of the subject. Okay. So in that way, I'm telling before only, thank you, Pranay, for bringing up some discussion here. Okay. So this hour we are talking about if circles are of equal radius. What if they're of different radius? Okay. If they're collinear, I think there is not much a discussion, but it's okay. Let's say I have a three circles of different radius. Okay, I guess I can take these two ends of diameter. It will contain all three, but there's a problem with the size of this. Okay, if this size goes too big, then it may not be. So in general, if somebody asks you, I'll give you three circles in XY plane, find a circle containing all three. Okay, it is not necessary that you should touch all three in general. It all depends on whether they are forming equitangle triangle, obtuse angle triangle, and so many other factors. Okay, so it depends on the question. And coming to the present question, I'll come back about equal radius and then discuss something. Let us say we talk about equitangle triangle. I have three circles of equal radius and equitangle triangle. Okay, this is a little closer. This is a little farther. All are of equal radius. And yes, there is a circle like this containing all three. How to find that is, you take this center, and this center and join. You will get a triangle. Further, there will be one circumcenter will be there. This will be capital R. This will be capital R. This will be capital R. Add two units. You can see all these lengths are same now. You take this R plus 2 as a radius and the same circumcenter as the center will definitely touch all three circles. Is it okay, Pranay?
Yes, sir. Why do I add two units, sir?
Oh, up to this, we have found the centers of the circles and joined a triangle. Further, this is a circumcenter. This distance is R, I am calling circumradius of triangle ABC. But that is not the radius of the big circle. Na? What is the radius of the big circle should be? What are the small radius? If these are all smaller, that's smaller you should have. Correct? Okay. So when this method is useful, when this center and this center and this center are forming an acute angle triangle and all three have equal radius. Is it okay?
Sir, they gave RS2, sir.
I'm telling, I gave in the beginning of the question, I explained it to you. If they are of different radius, this method is not going to help. Let us say I have this circle of radius 2, this circle of radius 3, and this circle of radius 4. Then, if I take this triangle, which has circumcenter where all these are capital R, R plus 2 is this, R plus 3 is this, R plus 4. Somebody says, why not take R plus 4 and draw a circle? That will definitely contain all three, no doubt. But that is not the smallest circle. I'm sure I can compress the big circle. Definitely some other circle will be there somewhat like this, which will contain all three. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yeah. So the circumcenter, finding the circumradius of triangle of with vertices as centers and adding this R value to that. You can only use that when two conditions. What is that? All three should have same radius and the centers are forming a triangle which is acute angle triangle, not obtuse angle triangle. Is it all right? Okay, now coming to the present question, the answer is not right for this reason. Why? Let us look at the question. Okay, so I always wanted to remove that question, but I wanted to replace with a similar question, so it was just left like that. Okay, so 0, 0, 8, 0, 0, 6. This point is 8, 0. This point is 0, 6. This point is 0, 0. There's a circle of radius 2 units here. There's a circle of radius 3 units here. And there's a circle of radius 4 units. So if you look at the answer, they just simply took the circumcenter of this right angle triangle, which is 3, 4. All these are 5 units. Here I'd add 3 extra, here I'd add 2 extra, here 4 extra. So they took 3, 4 as a center and 9 as the radius, and they gave this circle content. But that is not the circle of least radius. That is the problem. I'm sure you can easily do. Okay. How to find exact answer? I'm sure we can do something about it. We can assume it is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c. You should touch this. Some condition can be applied. Okay, but some work is there for that. It has to be done. All It may be quite very well possible that you take these two as ends of diameter, it may contain this. I'm not sure, I have to check that. Because this is a little less radius. I'm sure that is quite possible. Okay. So 35 answer is given 3, 4 center means 4, 3. Sorry, this is 4, 3. -8x, -6y. Okay, option D, they might have given key, but I told you why it is wrong. Is everybody clear about 35?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think I should take this as ends of diameter. That circle will most probably contain this, and that will be the answer. Okay, touching all three may not be, here also may not be possible. That means for minimum case. What is this length? 10 units. This is an extra 3 units. This is an extra 4. 10 plus 3 plus 4 is 70. Okay. And I have to take midpoint of these two as the center, not this 4, 3, some other point. I'm sure this will not be very high because 8.5 is quite a big number. This is after all 2 and even at best if it is 6. Yeah, here it is 6, still it is less than 8. It may contain, but some working is required. Okay, so 35 we are going to leave it because it's not that easy to find. Okay. Oh, time is up. I have another class now. Okay, I'll stop. Every day, please remind me. Don't mind. Okay. Thank you. We'll see tomorrow.
Thanks.
Okay, please complete all the MCQ questions for tomorrow. Okay.